Hi everybody, fantastic to see you all again. So this really is going to be around about a 5 minute midweek video, hopefully. What I wanted to talk about was last Sunday's video actually. I'm here in the Lake District at the moment making this Sunday's video, and I'm doing it right this time, unlike last Sunday's video. So I made a lot of mistakes in last Sunday's video and I didn't quite get the photos that I wanted. Now, I'm sure everyone will agree that the photos were good. I was pleased with them, but they could have been so good because the light was so spectacular. And I actually got lucky in the end because the best shot was the one when I was just walking home. And I wanted to talk a little bit about mistakes in photography and how I think that, you know, making mistakes is important, but it's also important that you learn from those mistakes and then, you know, you try and improve. And, you know, you think I know better because, you know, the thing that biggest mistake that I made in that shoot was I gave myself about an hour and three quarters to go and make a video and shoot some shots, and it was hectic. You know, I did some drone footage, I did video, I did B-roll, and I tried to get a composition. So let's look at what I did well first. So I arrived at the scene probably in reasonable time for the sunset if I'd have known where I was going, but I didn't know where I was going. I didn't really know much about the location, which I'll get onto in a minute. What I did well was I didn't try and be too ambitious and get the best shot. And I've spoken about this before. Sometimes you're better sticking with a composition and rather than trying to find one if you haven't got a lot of time with light, try and find a better one. Because if you keep trying to find a better one and a better one and a better one, then you end up just thinking, oh, I should have stayed where I was. That's not always the case, but predominantly that's the case. And I did that reasonably well. I think I moved twice to get the actual shot that I stuck at for about 45 minutes where the waves were coming in and the light was really diffuse and beautiful into the lighthouse. But what I wanted was to be down on the beach, and I wanted to be really close, you know, by the sea. And the thing I didn't realise was that high tide wasn't a great time to go and shoot that location. I'd done no research online. I'd not looked at Google Maps. I'd not looked at anybody else's photos. The only reason I went to that lighthouse is because I was looking at that lighthouse for the whole week out of my cottage window. So what I should have done was just done a little bit of research. And to be honest, I was having a bit of a break, so I just didn't want to think about photography too much. But if I'd have done a little bit of research, then I'd have found out that, you know, I probably should have gone further down. I could have got down a little bit there. Ideally, I should have gone at low tide, which would probably meant that I probably could have gone at sunrise, although I wouldn't have been shooting into the sun then, but it would have given a different dynamic to it. But the most important thing is time and giving yourself time at the location. And I just want to talk a little bit more about that and how, for a few shots that I've done in the past, how time has enabled me to get that extra special shot. You're probably thinking, why have you not got your hat on? So I'm hot. Does anybody know in England where I can get a giant's hat? This one has seen better days and probably need to replace it. If you do, then if you can post it in the comments below, I'd be massively appreciated. I think about time in two different ways. There is time in terms of how much time you spend on a particular shoot. And in that case, that shoot, I spend way too little. An hour and a half is never going to be enough. I think 3 hours is probably okay. If you've got more, then that's better. The more time you've got, the more chance you've got of getting better light, and the more chance you've got of finding that perfect composition. And then the other thing is time in terms of the time you spend at a location over a longer period of time. And I think that's really important. It's why that I go back to the same places all the time, because I like to get familiar with them. I'm coming here to check out the heather before I know that the heather's going to get a little bit better in 2 weeks. Now, I know that I've got that luxury, you know, I'm a professional landscape photographer, I can go back. But if there is somewhere near you and you go in the evenings, don't try and explore new locations all the time. Try and go back to the locations that you've maybe got an okay shot but not a perfect shot. And then what you'll do is you'll find that perfect composition, that composition that all you need is the light to be right. Or maybe you need to go back in the winter when the sun is just at a slightly different angle. But by understanding a location and spending more time in a location, I guarantee you'll get better shots. So take this shot here from Elgol in the Isle of Skye. I spent 3 days on purpose there, and I stayed in a cottage in Elgol. I didn't drive at all for those 3 days. I just went down to the beach in the morning, in the evening. I did some astro, and I think I spent about 30 hours in total just on the beach. And that meant that I started to understand where the light was falling, how the light was interacting with the land. And that's what gives you a better chance of getting a good shot. Okay, I'll tell you about another shot in a minute. But first, I've got to get through this gap, which is not easy. I'm going to have to take my bag off and lift it over my head, I think. Made it. Woo. Oh. And then there's this shot at Buttermere. And this took quite a lot of planning. So there was, I knew that it'd be a really good place to go at that exact time of year because the light would come through then. We got lucky a little bit with the light, but just knowing exactly where to go, knowing where the stream was going to come in from the left-hand side meant that when that light came for that brief moment, I was in the right place at the right time. And it's the same with that Enchanted Oaks. I've been to take photos of Enchanted Oaks about 50 times, and it was only that very last time you saw that it worked. Even 2 days earlier, I didn't quite get the mist that I wanted to, but I knew, and I fine-tuned that composition on that shot 2 days earlier, but I'd already been there a lot to get a composition that I knew I'd really like when the light came good. Your time is really important, and I think if you spread your time thinly over multiple locations, then you'll end up getting average shots. Okay, you probably get lucky like I did when I was walking back on Sunday and got that shot, but more often than not, you'll probably get an average or at best a good shot. Not that really amazing portfolio shot that we all want. Oh, so I've come here to scout actually, and I'll talk more about that on Sunday in this location and a few other locations. But I'll leave you with just a little idea, and that is just go back to a location you've been to before and try and find some good compositions. But then when you go back, when the light is amazing, just think about just doing less compositions. You know, just try and choose a composition and wait for the light rather than going to multiple compositions. Go back from that shoot with maybe 2 or 3 compositions rather than 5 or 6, and I guarantee you'll get a better shot. If you spend more time in your photography at one location, it'll definitely improve your photos. Okay, till Sunday, bye.